Hi, my name is Freedom. Today I'm going to show you how to create any fonts, the 3D fonts into iClone. So first, you need to stand by the iClone, and also this software, what we call the SketchUp. So first you open your SketchUp. Here you right click. Large tool set, you have to take it. Here, you have a 3D text. Click the 3D text and wait for a while. Here, enter any text that you want. Here you can choose any font. You have a lot of patterns. As long as the font already installed in your Windows font folder, I show you. It is in your C window font. All the font installation is at this folder. So if you require more, then you can go and download or purchase. Here I have a lot of fonts. So in SketchUp, I just need to type in. For example, I choose this one. You're not satisfied if I choose this. I place it. Here. So now this font is appear in 3D. The next step is to export it out. Here I open a new folder. This is my demo to export font. So open this folder, copy the location of this folder. Control C and back to your SketchUp, File, Export 3D Model. Here you have a lot of choices. I already tried one by one. The best is to convert it to export as 3DS file. I copy this destination location, I copy, paste here. Enter. Demo 01. Font demo 01. I put a random file name as demo. Export it out. Then click OK. The next, you need 3D Exchange. Open your 3D Exchange. Drag in your font and wait for a while. So at here, rotation 27, sorry, rotation 270, enter. This 270 is wrong. 90, enter. Okay, now it appears correctly. So where is the center? The center should be somewhere here. I can click Ctrl A to show the axis. After rotation, I click Reset Transform. Align to center. Align to ground. Then Reset Transform again. Now, all these fonts already can send to iClone, apply to iClone. All these fonts appear as 3D. You can set it as a prop, custom, prop, Then I click plus. Font demo 001. So now I already set it as a prop that you can use it anytime. Double click, delete. So at here you can treat it as a prop. You can either press E to rotate it, you can press R to do some transformation. How about changing the color? Okay, I click here, then I hold the shift key, then I press home. Okay, cannot. So I have to select one by one. I hold the shift key, press the down button until everything selected. So come to the diffuse color. I try to change the color. Change the diffuse color. Make it bigger. So I just do another demo. File, new. We don't want this to overlap, so file new. I don't want to save this. I delete this paper. So create a new font with other languages. For example, I type some Chinese word. 文字示范. So now I also try different symbols. I place it. Okay. Undo. I try again. I forget to select the font. Okay, this one I copy as backup. I copy all this and I paste here. Select some of the special font size. Some can be complicated. So how about this? I try to place it. This is quite amazing. Okay, so now I use the same method, export it as 3ds file, file export, 3d model, 3ds, demo 02, export. The more words you created, the longer it takes to render all this. Do not save as FBX file. The FBX file will always overlap between the fonts. So the best format is convert to 3ds. Feel done. Open your folder. Drag into 3D Exchange. This one. Repeat the same step. Rotation 90 at here, enter. Align to center, align to ground, reset transform, then apply to iClone. So I can make it bigger. Pretty awesome. Okay, thank you for watching. If you feel all these tutorials are helpful to you, if you love my video, you can subscribe my video.
Go to the bottom of the video and click subscribe. Click the bell to receive all the notifications for every time I publish a new video and tutorial if you love it. If you find it helpful, I will keep on post more and more tutorials for you. Into the